Sinbad's fourth voyage. It was not long before Sinbad sailed away again, this time from a Persian port. Their ship was, however, wrecked by a violent hurricane wherein most of the people died. Sinbad was one of the fortunate survivors who reached the shore of an island. After sleeping, the men awoke to search the island for help. Seeing a few huts, they started walking towards them when they found themselves surrounded by dark men from the village. They were captured and taken into their huts. Sinbad and five men were given some herbs that the others ate. They were immediately driven mad. Sinbad pretended to eat and was safe. The villagers then fed them rice, which the others ate. Sinbad was alert and understood that they were being fed so that the villagers might eat them after they were sufficiently fat. While his companions were eaten up, he became thin and saved himself. Freedom from cannibals. Considering him quite harmless, the villagers set an old man to guard Sinbad and permitted to walk around. One day, Sinbad ran away to the shore where he found some white men collecting pepper. To Sinbad's relief, they spoke Arabic. He told them about adventures, particularly the wild men on the island. Collecting the pepper they needed, they left the island, taking Sinbad to their own country, where their king welcomed him and treated him with great hospitality. Sinbad founded a prosperous kingdom, but everyone rode horses bareback. No bridles or stirrups were used, so he asked a craftsman to make a beautifully embroidered saddle and some spurs, which he presented to the king. The king was delighted and happily rode using this new saddle and spurs. He requested Sinbad to get them made for all his ministers and officers. Sinbad had become a royal favorite and was popular too. Buried alive, Sinbad became very rich soon, receiving many gifts from the king, who finally insisted that Sinbad should marry a beautiful lady and stay in his kingdom. After much argument, Sinbad finally agreed and got married to a lady chosen by the king. They were happy till something unfortunate happened. The wife of Sinbad's neighbor was dead. Sinbad came to know that according to the law prevalent in the kingdom, when a person died, the wife or husband was buried alive with him or her. Struck with horror, Sinbad saw his neighbor's wife being taken for burial along with the husband. After her body was placed in a large pit, her husband was given 7 loaves of bread and a jar of water and buried alive in the pit with her. This happened even to foreigners. Unfortunately, Sinbad's wife died and poor Sinbad was also buried. He sat in the dark pit trying to make the bread and water last longer. Unlucky escape. When the loaf and water finished, Sinbad was desperate. Then a dead man was buried in the pit with his poor wife. Sinbad heard a faint sound and followed it till he found a crack in the wall. Though it was very narrow, he crawled through it till he saw a dim light. The passage led to the shore. Returning to the pit, Sinbad collected all the jewels and valuable things and went to the shore. Luckily, he saw a ship and waved to it. He was picked up in a boat sent by the captain and taken to the ship. The sailors were very kind and helpful and did not take any payment from him for helping him. Sailing with them, Sinbad purchased goods and traded at the ports and the towns till they reached Baghdad. Sinbad's family and his friends were so happy that they celebrated his return. The Envious Man. In a small town a long time ago, there lived two neighbors. One of them envied the other very deeply. The man who was envied decided to shift to a different town to avoid the envious man. So, outside the capital of the kingdom, he found a small house with a well in the courtyard and a garden. He became a saintly man, a dervish, and gave the rooms of his house to other dervishes to live there. His goodness spread to everyone and he became famous. People came to visit the holy man and seek his prayers and blessings. One day, his old neighbor heard of him and hated him even more for his popularity and goodness. He went to the dervish, who treated him with kindness and courtesy. The envious man asked him to walk out with him, and leading him to the well, he pushed him in to kill him. Inside the well, the dervish who was pushed into the well did not die. The well itself was a magical place in which jinns and fairies lived. When he recovered from the shock of falling, the dervish heard them talking to one another and could understand them. One of them said, "This is a very good and holy man who came to live here to get away from his envious neighbor." But the man followed him and pushed him into this well. "But tomorrow the Sultan is coming to meet him," said another. "He wants a cure for the princess who has been put under a spell by the genie Maimun." "How can she be cured?" asked another. "The dervish has a black cat with a white tip on her tail," said the other. "If 7 hairs from the tail are burnt and the perfume of the smoke is applied to the princess's head, she will be well." The princess is cured. The dervish found footholds and climbed out of the well. The other holy men were delighted to see him back. Even the black cat came to rub her against his leg. He pulled 7 white hairs out of her tail and kept them. When the Sultan visited him the next day, he asked for the princess to be brought there. When she came, he lit a brazier and placed the 7 hairs on the coal. He allowed the fragrant smoke to circle her head. Her veil dropped and there was a loud cry. The princess, who seemed to have been unconscious, suddenly woke up. The cry came from the genie Maimun, whose spell had been broken. The Sultan was delighted to see his beloved daughter cured and gave rich gifts to the dervish and his disciples. He also declared that the princess would marry the dervish. The Just Sultan. Sometime later, the Wazir died and the Sultan appointed the dervish in his palace. The dervish was the son-in-law of the Sultan, who had no sons. Therefore, when the Sultan died later, the ministers, the soldiers, and the citizens were very happy to have the dervish as the new Sultan. One day, as the Sultan rode through the city, crowd gathered to cheer him. He saw the envious man in the crowd and sent one of the soldiers to fetch him. The new Sultan told his wazir, "Give this man 1,000 gold coins and from my own store give him 20 wagons full of merchandise. Then send a troop of soldiers to escort him to his home." The envious man was amazed at the generosity of the Sultan and bowed to him humbly. Everyone praised the Sultan for his great mercy and nobility towards the man who tried to kill him.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Book House.